Message begins right now. Note, by no means does this blog intend to put stamps or labels onto people and put some people over others. No one is better or worse, as we are all part of the whole. The categorization used in this article is only there to help understanding symptoms and the awakening and ascension process better. The transitions between the waves are fluent. Since the beginning of 2017, we are experiencing very new energy frequencies, something that has never been here before. To be precise, it already started building up on December 18th and continuously increased, with shorter breaks in between. These new energies come directly from the central sun, the cosmic heart, the ultimate zero point. Depending on where people are at in their journey and what ascension waves of ascension waves and their maga are in, the perception and experience of these energies can be very different. Before we go into the details per wave, I would like to introduce a practical way to understand the process of ascension waves and their magnitude. They also follow mathematical patterns. In order to make this very visual, I'd like to use the model of diffusion of innovations by Everett Rogers, a professor for communications. This model is usually used in marketing and PR to understand and address target groups better and how they align with the product life cycle. When an innovation is introduced to the market, the model follows the statistical bell pattern. There is a small percentage of first movers or innovators, 2.5%, that are the ones desperately waiting for the next innovation to come out. They are embracing changing thing. They are willing to take risks and test the unknown without any guarantee of a certain outcome. They pave the way for others to follow. They are way showers and leaders. The innovators are followed by the early adopters, a second, a bit larger percentage, with 13.5%. They are excited about everything new as soon as it has been proven to work by the innovators, and then love to follow these new trends full-hearted. They often take leadership positions as well. The next typology category is the early majority. That is when a product is already produced in masses. The early majority follows the innovators and early adopters, as they have proven and tested that the product is worth buying. They trust that new trend and or change. After having read and learned enough about it, they represent a big portion with 34.5%, just as large as the portion of the late majority. Those are the ones in general hesitant with innovations and change. They love to stay in their comfort zone as long as possible before the technological and social pressure gets too high, so they will feel the need to adapt in order to still be able to keep up. They are followed by the laggards, the ones that will only change their behavior when circumstances force them to. For example, because no one is selling videotapes anymore, so they are forced to change to a DVD player. The chart shows them with a portion of 16%, but to be completely correct, there is another group, those that will never adapt. They will be another 2.5%, which gives the laggards 13.5%. To complete the picture, the yellow line in the chart is the market share, meaning the growth of product availability. The different ascension waves in a model. Now looking at this model, isn't it striking how it can serve to describe the different ascension waves? The first movers being the ones that bravely walked into the unknown with a trial and error approach to find out how the energies and the universal laws work and how to cleanse and heal the physical and the different energetic bodies. They could only rely on channelings, ancient teachings, science, and had to trust their experience and intuitive knowing. Followed by the early adopters, the second awakening wave that is appreciating the insights and teachings of the first movers and picking them up quickly, transforming even faster. These two waves have gone through a lot of very intense energetic changes since December 2012. To prepare themselves for being ready to assist the first wave of mass awakening. These two waves have gone through a lot of very intensive energetic changes since December 2012, to prepare themselves for being ready to assist the first wave of mass awakening, which started to wake up mid-2016. This first big wave of ascension will go through everything that the first two waves have experienced, in an even more accelerated way, with the assistance of the first two waves and their experiences, to be prepared for the next big awakening wave of the late majority, which will probably start to wake up in 2020, depending on the timeline choices we make as a collective and how well we do in assisting each other through this first large wave. The market share line is representing the average light quotient on Earth in this adapted approach. These waves are not to be confused with the three waves of volunteers, Dolores Cannon, which categorize people in rough human age groups and characteristics. These waves depicted and described here depend much more on the willingness of people to move forward and beyond being human. Free will allows to accelerate or delay the awakening process, depending whether people choose love or fear. Thus, someone who was still completely asleep a couple of years ago can be a first mover, while someone who has been aware of spirituality and their gifts for all their life can still be part of a later wave. This has not much to do with experience or human age. It much more depends on the ability of an individual to raise the personal frequency and the understanding and living in accordance with universal law. This has not much to do with experience or human age. It much more depends on the ability of an individual to raise the personal frequency and the understanding and living in accordance with universal law. As everything in the universe comes in wave patterns, it is no surprise that the awakening process also takes place in waves. Just imagine, the whole humanity would wake up at once. There would be total chaos, and no one could calm down anyone and show the way. Now that we have understood the different waves a bit better, what is going on energetically for the different waves right now? First movers, innovators. The first movers are finally experiencing the ultimate relief. The last bits of fears disappeared and they are swinging back and forth between bliss and neutrality. The neutrality is something to get used to. It feels like walking through a movie, seeing people caught up in human drama and nothing touches or triggers emotionally in a painful way anymore. They see everything from a soul perspective, and the higher purpose of everything going on. Even terrorist attacks, mass shootings and death cannot trigger them anymore. All of it is perceived as unreal and part of a fake computer program. Often it feels a bit like an emptiness and boredom when the bliss takes a break to allow the integration of these highlight codes. Once the ego mind is transformed into a free spirit, it cannot relate to these low frequencies of drama and fear any longer. It has stopped interpreting anything. There are no doubts, worries, beliefs, expectations or fears. First movers are living from their heart and completely in the now. They trust the process and know that they will always be provided with everything they need and much more. They have detached from all material belongings and do not depend on them anymore. They have become fearless and have established a permanent connection to the cosmic heart, source, through their own heart. Mind and heart are aligned and are playing and creating together. Thoughts are now purely intentional. Manifestation comes easy. First movers are experiencing more and more abundance now on all levels, be it career, health, relationships and/or money. They experience a new lightness and playfulness, being childlike again and at ease with all that is. First movers now often feel like walking the fine line between the duality poles, not being drawn into any direction anymore, but balancing out the last bits of these poles. They often now feel like walking the fine line between the duality poles, not being drawn into any direction anymore, but balancing out the last bits of these poles. They know that neither way carries their truth. They have become like a blank slate. They have reached a state of complete authenticity, freedom and trust, a state of complete self-love, the basis to be completely aligned with Source, the cosmic heart, and with it, with unconditional love. This leads to a change in the perception of information. Channeling becomes intuitive knowing, As the merging with all that is has taken place, they are no longer receiving the situation from the outside but from within. There is no more need for psychics, tarot cards, pendulums, etc., as the knowing is just there. No more desire to research or read, as the deep knowing is there, that the right information will be delivered and will find them at the right moment. It can still be a challenge for many to trust that new quality of getting information, as it can first feel like being completely detached from guides, angels and star family. First movers are still dealing with physical cleansing, healing and restructuring, related to the extreme rewiring of the brain and the activation of further DNA codes and strands. That leads to headaches, glary eyes, a sore throat with some coughing and the flaring up of old physical weaknesses that are to be cleared now for good. All of this happens to be able to increase the ability and receptiveness for the fifth dimensional frequencies, for example the A's preparing to see higher frequencies, the voice bands to express higher frequencies. The mind is very foggy, memories are fading away more and more, time is dissolving completely. First movers have a hard time to remember what happened even an hour ago. They also experience more and more timeline switches, reality changes, and can lead to fun surprises, be it finding the car keys in a completely different space than having left them, or a tree is all of a sudden standing somewhere where it had not been before, clouds appear and disappear, or a blog you had read just the day before is nowhere to find anymore. These are just a couple of examples. Many first movers currently have intense and multi-layered dreams with complete detachment. They are very lucid and the mind is very active in processing it. It is a new sensation to have thought spirals without any attachment. This is part of the last bits of cleansing done in the higher dimensions. Sleep patterns do not exist anymore for the first movers. They might stay up a whole night or a couple of nights in a row without the need for sleep, just followed by periods of intense need for rest. In general, sleeping and waking states seem to align more and more. Often it is hard to tell the difference between the two. The early adopters are still dealing with their core wounds and beliefs. They still experience their spiritual ego trying to take over the lead again and keeping them caught up in duality and certain beliefs. They are experiencing deep emotional clearing. Triggers can hide behind every corner. These are the most painful experiences, as those are the parts that hurt the most. Many feel the longing to exit and die because it seems too much to take. It seems so cruel to have to go through this after having done so much work. It is important to know and remember that it always gets darkest before dawn. Thought spirals and overthinking are very common, including intense worries, panic attacks, and the feeling of being alone and not good enough can be very present. Early adopters still tend to get caught up in the human chaos, duality and drama going on around them, for example by watching and following too many fear-based news, which can keep them stuck in ego thinking, including the need to interpret and judge facts and actions of people and taking sides. It takes discernment to get back onto the soul, heart level. Many early adopters now experience the need to let go of material things and are longing to own less to free themselves from any pressure to have to make money just to finance stuff. Early adopters already experience glimpses of the first mover reality, but they are not stable and balanced enough yet to maintain that energetic frequency, while still dealing with their core wounds. Early adopters already experience glimpses of the first mover reality, but they are not stable and balanced enough yet to maintain that energetic frequency, while still dealing with their core wounds. That causes a push and pull dynamic between surrender, trust and the need to control the process, not trusting it and doubting whether this is real. The dreams are also multi-layered and very lucid and can cause intense emotional breakouts as own old stuff and collective stuff is cleared simultaneously. physical symptoms are comparable to those of the first movers. Early majority. The early majority right now is deeply triggered by all the chaos on the planet. Potential wars, terrorist attacks, a new US president that nobody expected, relationships fall apart, health issues nobody can explain, which are nothing but ascension symptoms, lots of insecurity is experienced and people are triggered deeply in their old belief system. They are afraid of having to leave their comfort zone. At the same time, the deep knowing is there, that something goes wrong with the old system and that this is not working any longer. There is this feeling that there can be a different way, and there is this longing of leaving the old life behind and finally do what they love. The ego is fighting hard to rationalize everything and to keep the lead and keep up the fear patterns. Nevertheless, the early majority now starts to research and find information about science and spirituality, about universal energies and what is happening. Their soul pushes them steadily into challenging the status quo and finding a new truth and reality. They experience unexplainable emotional breakouts and endless thought spirals, paired with the question, "Who am I, and what is my purpose?" As they have started their heart opening, they become vulnerable to the energies around them, which leads to a need of often pulling back and being alone. Often, they do not recognize themselves anymore. A lot of things they used to value lose their meaning to them. The feeling of being completely alone with their experience is paired with the fear that people might consider them to be completely insane. First, paranormal experiences like astral travel, clairaudience, clairvoyance or clairsentience are common, which adds to the feeling of going nuts. Many are going into the dark night of the soul, not seeing any sense or purpose in anything anymore. Dreams can be nightmarish and very intense, bringing up lots of fears and trauma from the past. The late majority, the laggards and the non-adapters, these groups are presently still completely asleep and still experience their reality from a fear-based ego perspective. They are in competition mode and believe in the theory of the survival of the fittest. Spirituality to them is absolutely bollocks, and people experiencing this need a medical treatment in their view. They can only see and feel the human drama and are either going into victim or perpetrator mode. They interpret, they judge, they blame. For them, the world is a dark place where everyone is on their own and needs to fight hard for their existence. There is only fear and lack frequencies with rare moments of joy. The ego is in the lead and keeps them in the past or in the future, constantly projecting things that are not real. Their energetic system is completely closed, including the heart center, so there is no way they can feel the new energies and the unconditional love that comes with them. They are absolutely convinced that the matrix they are living in is the only reality. Nevertheless, they experience the increase in energies physically. They also have to deal with physical symptoms and headaches. Depending on the stamina of their physical body, heart attacks, strokes, cancer etc. can show up quickly and unexpectedly, as the physical body is not able to deal with these frequencies very well. Many of these souls have chosen to not make the transition into the fifth dimension while being alive. Lighthouses don't run around trying to save ships. No matter what stage of their soul journey people are in, it is important to recognize that each and everyone has made their soul choice in what they want to experience and learn for their own expansion and growth in this lifetime, before incarnating. In addition to that, everyone has free will and can choose fear or love. No one is better or worse. We are simply in different stages of the process we all go through and perceive different energetic frequencies and, through them, different realities. Everyone is responsible for their own reality. We always create our experience, be it consciously or unconsciously through the energetic vibration we are emitting. People will have to make their own choice whether they want to learn more and go through the awakening process and accepting the assistance of others who have experienced it already. But none of us can convince someone else or teach them something they are not ready for. As these wonderful quotes say, lighthouses don't run around trying to save ships and change yourself. Change the world. End of the message. Much love to all you soul sisters, brothers. Watch DNA previous videos for better understanding. New subscribers will be updated with the latest articles and informations. We hope this channel has helped you discover where to start on your actual spiritual path. It's a good karma to put to like, comment, subscribe and share with your beloved ones. Leave your suggestion in the field below. All the love to you, beautiful souls.